Hello again. So, another 15 minutes on slopes and equations of lines. We just got done talking about how slope is rise over run. That's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. We have some forms of equations of lines. We've got slope intercept form, which is y equals mx plus b. We've got point slope, which requires just a point and a slope. The point is x1, y1, and the slope is m. This is where we plug in our numbers if we try and find the equation of a line. We also have standard form, which is ax plus by plus c equals 0. Not very friendly for graphing unless you're graphing using the x and y intercepts. We're going to pick back up with some more examples on how to come up with some equations of lines given just a minimum of information. The point-slope form of a line tells us the absolute minimum we need to write the equation of a line. A point, x and y, and a slope. That's why it asks for that information. In my last example, we were given 2 points, we found the slope, we had to find our own slope, and then we used the point-slope form to find the equation of a line. We're going to go right to that this time and say that we have a slope of 2, and the point this time is not going to just be like 5, 7. The slope is given to us as the x-intercept. So my x-intercept is equal to 4. So when I have a point, I need an x and a y, but yet I said the x-intercept is 4. Well, where's the x and y? If you're crossing the x-axis at 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, what is the coordinate of that point? Well, the coordinate of that point is 1, 2, 3, 4, 0. So when I say the x-intercept is 4, it only seems like you're given one number. I'm actually giving you 2. You do have the x and the y coordinate. So below here, we have a point, again, 4, 0. That's going to be my x and my y. We're going to find the equation of the line. The equation of a line, the point-slope form says y minus y1. So y minus the y value of my coordinate is 0 equals m, that's the slope that I was given of 2, times x minus x of 1, which is 4. Okay, now a lot of textbooks, and I won't be happy if my kids give me an equation in this form, because other than memorizing the point-slope formula, they haven't done anything. So we like to have these, I like to have these, set equal to y, because they're also very easy to graph when y is by itself. So we're going to get rid of these parentheses, and we're going to do that by taking the 2 and multiplying it through. Subtracting 0 doesn't do anything, so I'm not going to show that anymore. Y equals 2 times 1 is 2x. 2 times negative 4 is negative 8. And bam, I got my slope-intercept form. Y equals mx plus b. So in case you aren't very good about graphing lines, let's do that. This is my slope of 2 over 1. Now I'm writing it like a fraction because you need a rise value and a run value. Rise is either up or it's down. It's up if it's positive, and mine is. And the bottom number, I always read graphs left to right. That's not exactly a necessity, but I like to take my up and down movement as my positive movement or my negative movement, the bottom number always to the right. The last number over here is my y-intercept, my b. So b is equal to negative 8. When you're graphing a line in slope-intercept form, you do the y-intercept first, almost said the wrong thing. You do the y-intercept first of negative 8. And then you do what the slope says. Let's see if we can graph it and get it to pass to this point like the information said in the first place. It's in blue, so I'll keep it in blue. The y-intercept is negative 8. Remember, the y-axis is the one that goes straight up and down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now my slope is 2 over 1. So up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. And there's no reason for you to do this many repetitions, but look, I just counted my way back to the point I was given to in the first place. Pretty cool. So here's my line. Y equals 2x minus 8. I got time for another one. Let's take a look at do a weird one. Let's say that my slope was undefined, and the point that I'm going through is, I don't know, 2, 4, or negative 2, 4. Wow, I just told you that to find the equation of a line, you need a point and a slope. I have a point, but my slope is undefined? How am I supposed to plug into this equation the point-slope form if I don't have a slope? If you watched the last video, I kind of made some my arm movements here, trying to show you some stuff. If you have a line going up to the right, that is a positive slope. If it's falling down to the right, that's a negative slope. Horizontal lines, that's a slope of zero. And if you have a vertical line straight up and down, those lines have an undefined slope. So unless you have that memorized, there's nothing you can do with this question. You're not going to be able to answer it. This means that you have a vertical line. And vertical lines have the equation of x equals a number. And in this case, the x of the point that the line is going through is negative 2, so the equation is x equals negative 2. And that's it. There's no x's and y's going on because the line's very simple. It's straight up. The only thing changing is the y, and I don't have to know that. All I have to know is that the x is staying a constant x value of negative 2. Huh. Well, if that's a special case and it's pure memorization, what if I had a slope of 0? Well, if I have a slope of 0 and you don't know the definition, you can still work your way through the algebra and get the right answer. But if you know that, okay, this is a slope of 0, horizontal lines have a slope of 0. Well, horizontal lines don't have the equation of x equal number. Horizontal lines have the equation of y equals a number. So y equals a number is the form we have for horizontal lines. And what's the y value of this point that I'm going through? So take that number symbol out, y equals 4, and there's your answer. So there's two examples, one in the old video, one in this one, about finding equations of a line. You need a minimum of a point and a slope. But there are these special cases, and if you don't have these memorized, you're going to get those wrong. Let's see here. I got a few minutes. I think I have a minute left. Let's just one more time take a look at graphing a line. We're going to graph y equals 2x. Well, slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. And I've got the y by itself, so it is in slope-intercept form, but it's, oh, well, there's mx. There's nothing over here. A lot of us will know what that means, but if you're just starting off in algebra, you might not realize that they're telling you that the y value, the y-intercept, excuse me, is 0. We don't have to write plus 0, because what's 5 plus 0? It's still 5. It doesn't do anything. Well, we have a slope of, you know what, let me make this a negative. Negative 2/3, so you can see that movement. So this line has a slope, which is negative 2/3. Now here's where I'd like to talk about your slope. It's negative. I like to say the top number is rise up or a drop down, and it is going to go down because the slope is negative, and I like to say the bottom number is always to the right. Read those things left to right. So we have a slope of negative 2/3. We have a y-intercept of equal to 0. And again, one more time, when you are in slope-intercept form, you want to graph those with the y-intercept first and the slope second. So this first, this second, here's your line. Yes, I do kind of write hard, so I break my chalk often. Y-intercept is 0. Done. Slope, down 2 over 3. Down 2 over 3. Or just to highlight it again, down 2 over 3 to make my new point. And there's my line. Let's just say for a second that this were y is greater than or equal to negative 3. Now I have an inequality. That means shading. Where do my y's get bigger? Greater than. This is y is greater than. Where do y's get bigger when you go down? No, y's get bigger as you go up. That's a y value of 1, 2, 3, 4. So that inequality, when you get to that in your algebra or algebra 2 book or geometry, will indicate that you shade up. Thank you very much.
Bam!
I'm going to bam right back because I just realized I got a few more minutes to show you some more stuff. I graphed using slope intercept form twice. What about this guy down here, standard form? Well, standard form is good if you're going to graph equations of lines using x and y intercepts. Let's talk about that. So here's an equation, 4x plus 3y equals plus 12 or 10, 12 equals 0. And I want to graph this using x and y intercepts. If I don't know what's happening, I'm going to erase this in a second. What is happening when you cross, when the line crosses the x and y axis? If you're on the y axis, isn't the x equal to 0? If I go from the origin, that's up 2. So this point is 0, 2. So when you have a y intercept, the x is 0. This point over here that's on the x axis is 3, 0. 3, 0. So if I'm on the x-axis, my y value is 0. So y-intercept, x equals 0. X-intercept, y equals 0. I'm going to quicken this up just a little bit. I'm going to bring the 12 over with subtraction. 4x plus 3y equals negative 12. And we're going to find the x-intercept. You do that by letting the y equal 0. And these will fall away very quickly and you'll have your answers. 4x plus 3 times 0 equals negative 12. Okay, that's 0. So 4x equals negative 12. And x, when you divide both sides by 4, is negative 3. Let's find one more point, because you need 2 points to graph a line. My y-intercept is when you let x equal 0. That is going to be 4 times 0 plus 3y equals negative 12, and I'm almost out of space, so I'm going to remind you that 4 times 0 is 0, and we're left with 3y equals negative 12. Well, when you divide both sides by 3, 12 divided by negative 3, I'm undoing that multiplication, is going to be negative 4. So now I have 2 points. I've got an x-intercept and a y-intercept, and if I have 2 points, I can graph a line. And so can you. So we have an xy axis, we have an x-intercept of negative 3, we have a y-intercept of negative 4, and through those points, we have a line. Now I'm out of time. Thank you very much.